Hello children, this video is in continuation with the previous video about tense. Now, number 3, future tense. For referring the future, the model auxiliaries shall and will. Two words, shall and will, are used with the bare infinitive.
What is the meaning of bare infinitive?
Without two.
Verb without two.
So, to denote future tense,
which two words we use?
Either shall or will.
Now, first we'll talk about future tense.
Simple future tense denotes future action
with the help of will or shall plus V1 form of the verb.
Now, example.
We shall, with V1 form of the verb, go for a picnic tomorrow.
We shall go for a picnic tomorrow.
So it shows that the speaker is talking about the future planning, future tense. We shall go for a picnic tomorrow.
Next example.
He will reach by 30 p.m.
Here, subject is he, and the verb will reach V1 form of the verb by 5:30 p.m.
It is an example of future present tense.
Now the next aspect, future continuous tense. Now this tense denotes future action in progress.
Future action in progress. It will continue.
That's why it is future continuous tense.
It is also called as future progressive tense.
One more term is there to use progress, continuous, that is progressive.
So in English grammar you can call it as future progressive tense also.
In this, what will be the sentence structure?
We use either will or shall plus be as a helping auxiliary verb plus V1 form of V1.
So the sentence will be an example sentence for you.
We shall be playing football this evening.
So the sentence is we shall be playing football this evening.
Now the next example.
He will be coming to my house tomorrow.
He will be coming to my house tomorrow.
This shows continuous tense. Now the third one.
Future perfect tense. The third is future perfect tense. This tense indicates an action in the future that will have been completed before another time or in the future. It will be completed in the future sometime. It is continuing and it will be completed sometime in the future.
Its structure, the sentence. We'll use subject and then will or shall, future tense, and then we have to use have, this because it is perfect, denote perfect tense. So we'll use V3 form of the verb, V3 means past participle, okay? So example, by the time we arrive, the time we arrive, comma, he will have left the house.
Future, we are talking about the subject, will have left the house.
Now second example,
the train will have
departed.
The train will have departed.
Talking about the future.
About the train will have departed.
When we reach the station.
So will is showing that it is sentence in future tense.
And have showed that sentence is in future perfect tense.
Now the last one.
Future perfect continuous tense. Now this tense indicates an action in the future that will have been continuing.
It will have been continuing until another time, another event in the future.
So its form will be used to use future tense, will or shall, plus been, plus verb in ing.
So its format will be he will have been exercising an hour at 2 p.m.
He will be exercising an hour at 2 p.m.
And second example, he will have been in America in 2055.
He will have been in America in future.
He will have been in America in the year or in 2025.
Now here the tense forms and the complete information.
Information on the topic of English grammar.
Thank you.
God bless you.